जी बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम। डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वी आर वर्किंग इन एपिकल्चर फार्मर ट्रेनिंग लैब पीर मेयर ईशा एयर एंड एग्रीकल्चर यूनिवर्सिटी रावलपिंडी। टुडे वी शैल डिमॉन्स्ट्रेट हाउ टू डिटरमिन द मॉइस्चर कंटेंट इन हनी। मॉइस्चर कंटेंट इज वेरी मच इम्पॉर्टेंट क्वालिटी पैरामीटर टू डिटरमिन वेदर राइप हनी वाज हार्वेस्टेड बाई द बी कीपर और अनराइप हनी वाज हार्वेस्टेड। Then beekeepers harvest unripe honey, so many issues may develop. First one is increased moisture content in the honey, and the second one is the increased reproduction of the yeast, which is the main factor responsible for the deterioration of honey. So the beekeepers, they can determine whether the honey is ripe or not by two tests in the field. First one is that they can see if more than 70% of the cells on the honey frames are capped, it means that the honey is ripened. Second one is the shake test. They can pick the frame in their hand and shake on the box, and if some drops of honey or nectar they fall down, it means that the honey is not ripened. So they should wait for some days and again perform this test. If no drop falls from the frame, it means that the honey is ripened. And after the harvest of the honey, different beekeepers, they send their honeys in our lab to test what is the level of moisture content in their honeys. We have different samples. This one is from Miyawali, and it was harvested in May. This is the sample from Acacia, and it was harvested from curd. This is the sample of Apis cerana, which is also called paadi makhi, and it was harvested in June from Margla. This one is berry honey, which was harvested from last October in 2019 in Talagan. And this one is the sample of acacia, which was harvested from Laya side in May. So now, how to use the reflectometer to determine the moisture content of the honey? First, we should hold the reflectometer between our thumb and four fingers, just like this. So the scale in the reflectometer is between 20 to 30. Normally the value of moisture content in the honey ranges from somewhat 16 to 20. And occasionally it increases from 20. So this reflectometer, we will hold this one between our four fingers and thumb, and with our left hand we can adjust the visibility. So here we can see intersection in blue color when we place a sample of honey on the prism. So there is also a scale which is correction scale, because this reflectometer determines the moisture content at 20 degrees Celsius. If the temperature of the lab is more or less, then this adjustment scale adds the value or subtracts some value in the observed value, so we can accurately measure the moisture content in honey. So if the value of this reading is more than zero, if the value of this scale is above than zero, so that value will be subtracted from the observed value. And if this value is low than zero, this value will be added in the observed value. Now we shall test the moisture content of one of our samples, and this one is berry honey. So pour few drops of this honey on the stick and place this honey and spread uniformly on the prism. After spreading, we place the daylight plate on the prism and gently press so that there is no air bubble. After this, we see towards light and try to see the blue intersection on the scale. Here we are seeing the value of 19. So 19 is the observed value. We can write here the value of 19. And after this, we observe what is the value of adjustment scale. The value of adjustment scale. Now the value of 1.2 will be subtracted from the observed value. Observed value was 19 and the correction factor was 1.2 and the corrected reading becomes 17.8. So the value of miser content in this honey is 17.8. Although the value of 17.8 is the ideal, however, in Pakistan standards, the range of 20% moisture content is allowed. But the ideal moisture content should be less than 17.8, because when the moisture content increases, the reproduction of yeast, the growth and development of the yeast in the honey increases. So 17.8 is very good moisture content. After determining the moisture content, we should wash this reflectometer gently. With the help of this screw, we can separate the daylight plate and gently wash with wash bottle. It should not be placed under tap water, running tap water, because the prism is very much sensitive. Now we shall give another washing to the prism and gently clean the prism so that no drop of honey is left on the prism. So now the reflectometer is clean and is ready for another reading. So this was all about very important aspect of honey, how to determine the moisture content in the lamb with the help of a Tago HHR2N Japanese reflectometer. Thank you very much.